You'll sing it with us. It's called The Christians and the Pagans.
Culture uncle said we're up here for the holiday. Jane and I were having solstice. Now we need a place to stay. And her Christ-loving uncle watched his wife hang Mary on a tree. He watched his son hang candy canes all made with red dye number three. He told us this is Christmas Eve. I know our life is not your style. She said Christmas is like solstice and we miss you. And it's been a while. So the Christians and the pagans stay together at the table. Mind if they make common ground like this, they will be able. Just before the meal was served, hands were held and prayers were said. Sending out for peace on earth to all their gods and goddesses. The food was great, the tree plugged in. The meal had gone without a hitch till Timmy turned to Amber and said, is it true that you're a witch? His mom jumped up and said, the ties are burning, and she hit the kitchen. And it was Jane who spoke. She said, it's true because he's not a Christian. But we love trees, we love the snow, the friends we have, the world we share. And you find magic from your God, and we find magic everywhere. So the Christians and the pagans stay together at the table. Finding perfect common ground, the best that they were able. And where does magic come from? I think magic's in the learning. It's how the Christians sit with pagans. Only pumpkin pies are burning.
Take that, Donald Trump.
It's Christmas and your daughter's here. He thought his father's sons and brothers saw his own son tuck his sleeves in. Can I be a pagan? Dad said we'll discuss it when they leave. So the Christians and